In this tutorial, you'll learn how to edit a time-lapse video in Adobe Premiere Pro. Hey guys, I'm Chris and welcome to iStalker. As I said in the intro, today I'm gonna show you how to edit a time-lapse video using Adobe Premiere Pro. It doesn't matter what device that you use to capture the time-lapse sequence, it can be a smartphone, a GoPro, or a professional DSLR. As long as you use the specific interval to take the shots and you use the tripod, everything should be perfect in the end. Before starting to edit the time-lapse sequence, I want to show you a cool time-lapse calculator, which I embedded on my website. It's from photopills.com. I find it very easy to use if you want to plan your time-lapse before going on location. Let's say I want to find out the event duration or how much time do I need to shoot photos to obtain a 15 seconds time-lapse at 30 frames per second at a shooting interval or a time interval of 2 seconds. I can also enter here the size of a single photo, so let's say I will shoot with the GoPro 4 and that means 12 megabytes per photo. And here are the results. I will need to shoot photos for 15 minutes. I will have 450 files, which will take up 5.27 gigabytes on my SD card. So this is helpful information, guys. Feel free to use this tool. It's on my website and you can find the link down in the description. Now let me open Adobe Premiere Pro. I use the Creative Cloud version and I will import my whole photo sequence, which was shot on my GoPro 4 Black using the photo time-lapse mode. This allowed me to edit each photo individually in terms of contrast, saturation, and white balance. I made this thing using Adobe Lightroom, so if you want me to make a tutorial on that as well, just give me a thumbs up, and if this video reaches 200 likes as soon as possible, I will make that tutorial for you guys. So when you open Premiere, it will ask you for a project name. I will write time-lapse, then hit OK. Then you click on New, Sequence, and from here I will open HDV and choose the 1080p 30 frames per second preset. So now in this sequence, you will import your time-lapse shots, and you can do this in two different ways. The easiest and the most convenient way is to right-click inside the project area, choose Import, browse to the location with the photos, you select the very first photo, and you tick this box here confirming that this is an image sequence. And then you just click on Open. Premiere Pro will take all those shots, stitch them together and create this single file here, which you will drag then to your timeline. Yes, keep existing settings. The resolution of the sequence is 1080p, but my photos are much bigger than this, so I need to adjust their size. I select the single element here, right-click on it, and choose scale to frame size, and this should automatically solve the issue. Keep in mind that the photos that I'm using in the sequence are already adjusted to an aspect ratio of 16:9. But if you have problems with this, you can go to the Effect Controls panel here. If you don't have this, just go to Window, Effect Controls, and you have this scale option, which you can adjust to make sure that you don't have any black margins, like this for example. I will go back to 100% scale now. Okay, so this was the easy way. Now I will show you the harder way. Sometimes when you will try to import your photos by checking this box, you will see that Premiere will not bring in all your frames. So now I will show you another method to import your time-lapse photos. Right-click, Import, select the first photo from the sequence, press Ctrl+A to select all the shots, and then click on Open. It will take a while until Adobe Premiere will import your time-lapse shots. This will depend on your computer speed. When it's ready, you will see that you'll have a bunch of photos here in the Project tab. I have, for example, 671 files here, including the sequence file, so a total of 670 images. You can see that every image has a number here, 429. This means that if I drag this single image onto my timeline, it will last for 4 seconds and 29 frames. But I don't want that because every single photo from here should last one single frame. So, click on the first image, Ctrl+A to select all the files here, then hold down Control and deselect your sequence. We will work only with the images. Then right-click on one of the photos and choose speed/duration. Make sure you edit the numbers here exactly like I do now. And by this, you are telling to the software that every photo will last one single frame. Then click OK, and you can see here that the value is changed for every photo and the duration of each file is one frame. The next step is to click on this list view to make sure that your photos are ordered correctly. Otherwise, the time-lapse will not appear in the right way. Select the first frame here, scroll down to the end of the list, hold down Shift, select the last frame. You don't want to include the sequence, only the photos. Then scroll up and drag all the frames on the timeline by dragging the first frame with your mouse. After you made this step, you will see a dark block here, but if you zoom in, you will be able to see every single frame. So all the frames are placed one after another. While being here, you can press Ctrl A to select all the frames, then right-click on one of them and choose Scale to Frame Size. As you can see here, the frame looks good and we can have a preview just to make sure we made everything in the right way. So this was the second method. Now, I will show you how to render the sequence even if you used method 1 or method 2, it doesn't matter. I will go to File, Export, Media, or simply press the Ctrl M shortcut to open the render dialog box. I will choose H.264. Then as a preset, I will choose the HD 1080p 29.97 frames per second. I will take this box to use maximum render quality and also use previews. I will untick the export audio option, choose a name for my render, click save, and then click on export. The file is rendering now. I will speed this up and let's open the file now. So here is the time-lapse I have just exported. This is my method of editing a time-lapse. If you want to see how I prepared the raw frames in Adobe Lightroom, as I said in the beginning, please like this video, and when it reaches 200 likes, I will make that tutorial too.